fans, I'm the fidget spinner of mixed martial arts, Tommy Toehold, because I'm mildly entertaining for a few seconds and you haven't seen me since 2018. I've been working on a comeback episode for months now, but then this stupid ass shit happened and I want to talk about it. So this video isn't going to have a bunch of bells and whistles. I'm not doing any fighter interviews. Stone Cold Stipe isn't going to come out and give me a stunner. Let's talk about Logan Paul versus Floyd Mayweather. Actually, let's talk about Logan Paul. For those of you in my audience who aren't 14 years old, Logan Paul is a YouTuber who's famous for being what a teenager thinks an adult's life should be like because they grew up watching iCarly and fucking SpongeBob SquarePants. This meathead, who was a pretty solid high school wrestler, him and his less talented but more annoying brother Jake, who is more willing to exploit himself and others for financial gain, traveled out west from Ohio to pursue fame through Vine. Remember Vine? It was TikTok before Musical.ly. So these two got rich making shitty 6-second videos for middle schoolers while building a social media empire. Then Vine died, they came to YouTube, got even bigger doing terrible daily vlogs and god-awful music, while creating a whole army of equally vapid content creators and selling children shitty overpriced merchandise they hawk every 5 fucking seconds, while simultaneously going out of their way to never make a single thing of substance. In fact, the opposite. The worse their content, the more people talked about it, and the more money they made. Since filming a dead guy for the lulz, Logan's gotten lazy and started a podcast where he and his friends ramble on for hours about nothing because it's the easiest possible content to make. And Jake's been busy looting, getting raided by the FBI, holding massive parties in his mansion during coronavirus, and he fancies himself a boxer. Logan does too. He believes his superior work ethic and godlike body means he could be the best athlete in the world at any sport, he just hasn't chosen to do so yet. He and another YouTuber, KSI, manufactured some shitty beef to have an Emmy boxing match in 2018, which was a huge success, 1.3 million pay-per-view buys. The fight went to a draw, shocker. Jake was also on the card. He TKO'd KSI's little brother. The rematch happened last year at the Staples Center, this time as official pros promoted by Eddie fucking Hearn. KSI won via split decision, it streamed on DAZN, and was the third most watched event the service had ever done. Since then, Jake has had 2 pro fights. You probably saw him knock out NBA player Nate Robinson on the Tyson Jones Jr. card, more on that later. His first pro fight happened in January against some guy who plays FIFA a lot that also isn't a boxer. Jake's been busy calling out Conor McGregor, who he intends to fight after he defeats elite boxers Dylan Danis and Ben Askren, fresh off his hip replacement. Despite Jake's insane drive to do more and be crazier than his older brother, he's still not as popular or as interesting, and so the older brother was the natural choice for Floyd Mayweather when these two fucking sociopathic goofs came knocking. Now, Logan is 6'2" and over 200 pounds with a 4-inch reach advantage. Floyd is 5'8", and the heaviest he's ever fought was 154 pounds. None of these stats fucking matter, nor does the fact that Mayweather started boxing as a pro when this fucking dork was not even a year old. The danger in this matchup for either man is about as real as when Floyd fought the fucking Big Show at WrestleMania. 1. Logan Paul couldn't do a goddamn thing to Floyd Mayweather even if he wanted to. 2. If you're thinking it might be worth your buck to see this clown get knocked the fuck out, don't waste your time. In order for this exhibition to be made in any location that's not international waters, like the time Tyson fought Secretariat, this bout is gonna be so fucking heavily regulated on both the commission end and written into the contract. You think Floyd Mayweather is gonna walk into any fight without making 100% sure the risk is as minimal as possible? Nobody's getting knocked out here. Nobody's getting knocked down. I'd be shocked if this thing was booked for more than 3 rounds. You watched that Tyson Jones Jr. fight, right? How many times did it look like Mike was right about to light Jones up and knock him out, and then he just threw a flurry to the body? The commission made sure that fight was as safe as it could be. The same thing is gonna happen here. Logan Paul has no fucking combat sports experience. He's also gigantic. This isn't going to be an exciting fight on either end. You're gonna wish you streamed it illegally instead of giving these two fucks money. And it will do well. This will sell over 1 million buys. It'll be the biggest boxing match of 2021. And Jake, he will get that big fight. Probably not Conor, but somebody. For the first time in combat sports history, white collar boxing has become more popular than actual boxing. More profitable than actual boxing. So the question is, why the fuck even bother promoting anything but total bullshit? I've heard some saying how good all this is for boxing. Like the people who want to watch Logan Paul get KO'd, or the people who are actually somehow fans of these clowns give a single fuck about boxing. Boxing is universal because it's people punching each other. It's fighting. You don't need to care about boxing to appreciate somebody getting beat up. The interest is in these very specific people getting their asses kicked. It has nothing to do with the enjoyment of the sweet science. Jake Paul fight fans don't give a fuck about what happened at Spence Jr. versus Garcia. Don't give a fuck about Anthony Joshua's next fight. It's the same reason everybody watching Tyson versus Jones Jr. fucking loved hearing Snoop clown the entire time, because this isn't a boxing event. This is a full-on fucking freak show. Well, it's gonna make money, Tommy. Yeah, I could make a fuck ton of money by lacing gummy bears with heroin, but that doesn't mean it's a great idea just because it's profitable.